Hello my dear friends, I hope you're doing super duper wonderful, and in today's video you will learn how you can design this super duper awesome aesthetic slide in PowerPoint. Let's go! And first of all, I want to say huge thanks to Matthew Gold for inspiring today's video. I have found his work on Dribbble, link is in the video description, it's an art gallery website design. I absolutely love it, and I thought it would be fun to design a PowerPoint slide in the same style. So let's go! Okay, my friends, and first of all, let's jump into the slide master where we can set all of the fonts and all of the colors that we'll be using. So let's go to view slide master and let's look for fonts. Let's set up a font pair that we'll be using. Okay, we can set one font for the headings and one font for the body. And for the heading, I'm using a font called Kirimaro. It's an elegant free font, link is in the video description. And for the body, I'm going with Montserrat. And now we can just give a name to this font pair. Let's call it One Skill 2 because I've already played with a couple of fonts before. Okay, so as you can see, we have One Skill pair and we have One Skill 2 that we have just created. Okay, and now we can jump into colors. Let's go into customize colors. And over here we have 6 accent colors and we can change those colors, okay, for later use. So now let's change this first accent color, and to find some inspiration we can jump into this wonderful website colors or colors.co. And now let's just pick any color that we wish. We can just click for example on this color, and this way we can quickly copy the hex code. Okay, so the hex code has been copied, and now let's go to this accent one color, let's go to more colors, okay. And over here in this field we can paste in the hex code, and skadoosh, the first color has been set. And on the same way you can set the rest of these colors to any custom colors that you wish. I'm going to change accent 2 and accent 3 colors to custom colors, and the rest of the colors I'll just leave them the way they are because I think for this slide design 3 colors will be more than sufficient. Okay, so let me customize those colors and I'll catch you in a second. Okay my friends, so in the slide master view we have successfully set a font pair and some colors, and now let's get back to the normal view and let me show you how we can create these beautiful shapes on the right side and fill them with some pictures. So to create these shapes we'll be using other basic shapes such as rectangles and circles, and at the same time we can turn on the slide guides so that we can see where's the center of the slide. And now let's just draw a rectangle. We can hold down the shift key to draw a perfect rectangle. As you can see, this rectangle is picking up our custom color, that's beautiful. And now for the height and width for this rectangle, let's use 6.35 centimeters. This way everything is going to be easy peasy lemon squeezy. And by the way, as you can see, I'm using these fancy shortcuts. I can easily align this rectangle wherever I wish. And all of these shortcuts are possible thanks to BrightSlide, the free PowerPoint add-in which has productivity shortcuts. That's awesome. And now my friends, let's insert a circle. We can hold down the shift key to draw a perfect circle. Okay, just like that. And now let's make sure that the circle has the same height and width as the rectangle. So it should be 6.35. And once again, we can use the BrightSlide add-in. Let's make sure that both of the shapes are selected. And let's just click on this button, match size. And now skadoosh, both of these shapes have the same height and width, 6.35. And now let's position the circle just like that at the top right corner of the rectangle. And now let's duplicate this circle a few more times so that we basically have a circle at each corner of the rectangle, just like that. And now let's select all of these circles and let's group them, I mean union them. Let's go to merge shapes and let's choose union so that they become one solid shape, just like that. And now let's make sure that we send these circles to back so that they're behind the rectangle. Now let's select the rectangle first, then those circles, let's go to merge shapes and let's choose subtract. And skadoosh, this way we have made that awesome looking pointy star shape. Okay, now let's move it just below the center, and now let's make a few more copies, and basically you can create any pattern that you like. So let me copy a few more of these beautiful pointy star shapes, and let's align all of them to the right side of the slide, that's beautiful. And as you can see in the original slide, we have some semi-transparent shapes as well, so we'll have to do that as well. But before that, let's make sure we add that accent one color as our slide background fill color. So let's choose accent one. That's nice. Now we have this beautiful color as our slide background color. And next, let me show you how we can fill all of these shapes with any picture that we like. So let's jump into unsplash.com, an awesome place to find photos and pictures. And now let's just zoom into this photo and let's copy it. Link is in the video description if you'd like to use it as well. And now let's jump back into PowerPoint and now let's just select all of these guys. We can hit Ctrl A to select them all. Let's jump into the format shape. Now in the fill options, let's choose picture. Let's click on clipboard and skadoosh. This way we have pasted that photo as the fill for all of these shapes. That's awesome. We can as well make sure that we copy one of those shapes. Okay, let's align it to the edge, to the right edge, to the middle of the right edge of the slide. And as well, let's add some transparency, for example, 70%. And this way that shape becomes semi-transparent. And this is just purely a design choice, you know, just to make our slide design a bit more sophisticated. Okay, so a few more of these guys at the top and pretty much we're finished with those shapes. And by the way, here's one skill from the future showing you how to fix these photos because they're actually looking a bit squished. So let's just select one of those photos. Let's go into crop and just click on fill. And now this photo will look the way it should look like. Okay, we can select one of these guys, hit Ctrl Shift C to copy the style. Now we can select the rest of these guys and hit Ctrl Shift V to paste that fill option. And now all of these little photos are looking correct. So just keep in mind, if your photos are looking squished, you can just jump into the crop options and choose fill. Okay, my friends, and now let's continue with this beautiful slide title. So let's go into insert tab. Let's find that beautiful text box tool and let's just type in your slide. Okay, let's increase the font size to something huge, for example, 96 points, looking beautiful. And now for the heading, we can choose our beautiful heading font, Kirimaru. Okay, and for the font color, let's pick this shade of black. And as you can see, the spacing between lines is pretty huge. So let's go with multiple and let's choose, for example, 0.7. And now these two lines of text are closer together, which is looking much better. And by the way, let me jump into the text box options and let's make sure there are no margins. So let me just insert 0 centimeters. This way, this text box will look a bit cleaner. That's nice. And now, my friends, the question is how we should precisely position this text box on the slide. And for this purpose, I'm using guides. Once again, we can create these guides, these slide guides, with the BrightSlide add-in. Okay, so first of all, I have inserted margins of 1.5 centimeters. So this is basically a safe area around the edges of the slide. And next, I have 12 vertical columns and 30 rows. And all of these columns and rows will help me to space out and to position all of the elements on the slide. And this way, everything is going to be looking beautiful. So now I have decided to place this slide title somewhere over here. Okay, and as well, let's turn on the rulers so that we can see where is the center of the slide. So let's make sure that the slide title is barely touching the middle of the slide and it is touching the right side of the first column. Okay, and now we can just duplicate this text box by holding down the Ctrl Shift key and let's change the font to Montserrat. This is going to be our body text. Okay, and we can resize our body text box a bit so that we have more space inside. Let me just grab this text from the first line and let's paste it over here. That's nice. And let me check the spacing, the line spacing. We can jump into paragraph and we can see multiple 0.9. That's looking beautiful. Okay, let's make sure that we're using the same shade of black as our slide title is using. Okay, that's nice. And as you can see, we have exactly 2 rows of spacing between the slide title and paragraph text. So that's the bonus or the benefit of using guides because you can precisely space out the elements on your slide. Okay, my friends, and next let's create that little call to action button just below the body text. And for that, we'll be using a rounded rectangle. Let's make sure that those corners are fully rounded. Once again, 2 rows of spacing below the body text. Okay, let's make sure it is 2 columns wide. And for the width of the line, let's use, for example, just 1 point. Let's use the same shade of black and let's add a bit of transparency, for example, 50%, just for fun. Okay, and now my friends, let's make sure that we're using 14 points for the font size. Once again, the same shade of black, and let's just type in the address of one more awesome website, which is pptskill.com, where you can master PowerPoint animations. So definitely check it out. Link is in the video description as well. And now, my friends, let's create this awesome looking logo. Okay, so let me just go to the top left corner of the slide and create the logo, we'll have to use, first of all, a circle. Okay, so let's just insert a beautiful circle. Let me just copy the style from this rounded rectangle and apply it to this circle. Let's position it over here. Let's just zoom in so that we can better see what we're doing. And now let's just make sure that this circle is somewhere around 2 rows height. Okay, so it has height and width of 1.07 centimeters. That's nice. And now let me just duplicate this pointy shape. Let's make sure it is using a solid black fill or any shade of black or any other color that you wish. Okay. And now we have to make sure that both of these guys have the same size. And for that, once again, we can use this magical button called match size. Okay, so let's just zoom in a bit once again. Let's just center align both of these guys. Let's group them into a single group and let's just position them somewhere over here. And actually, let's fill this circle with some beautiful white color, just like that. And we'll have this nice looking static logo. And now let's just duplicate it and put it into this call to action button over here. That's nice. And by the way, for this rounded rectangle, let's change its fill. And before that, we can of course move the text a bit to the right side if we wish. And let's just change the fill to something more different. That's nice. For example, accent 2. That's looking beautiful. Okay, my friends, so we're doing a wonderful progress. And as you can see, the CTA button in the second slide is a bit higher than the button in the first slide. But that's okay. It wouldn't be as fun if everything were identical. And let's get back to our logo. Let's just duplicate the slide title. Let's resize it. Let's use, for example, 20 points for the size. And let's just move this little text box closer to our shape. And actually, for the font size, let's use 18. Okay, so that it pretty much has the same height as those two rows from our guides, just like that. Looking beautiful. And now let's just select the shape and the little text box and let's just group them into a single group. That's nice. And next, my friends, let's add a slide number. Okay, so let me show you how we can do that. And to customize the look of the slide number, we'll have to jump into the slide master, where you usually have to do these kind of things like changing the look of your slide number. So let's just grab this text box, which is responsible for the slide number, and let's just move it to the top. Not top, but bottom left corner of the slide, okay? And let's make sure that the text is center aligned. And now let's go to shape format, edit shape, and let's choose change shape, and let's choose circle. So this way our slide number text box will have a shape of a circle, but of course now it is not proportionate. So let's make sure that the height and width has the same numbers. So let's just use 1.07 for height and width. And now we have a perfect circle. And at the same time, let's make sure there is enough space for the text inside of this slide number text box. As you can see, we have a couple of strange looking arrows. Let's go into text options. Let's uncheck wrap text. And now the slide number should have enough of space inside of this circle. And let's position it just like that, just touching the left margin and bottom margin of the slide. And once again, for the line, let's use 1 point and the transparency of 50%, okay? And the same shade of black. That's nice. Okay, and once we're done, we can get back to the normal view. And to turn on the slide numbers, all we have to do is jump into the insert tab. Let's click on the slide number button and let's check this little checkbox slide number. Let's click apply and skadoosh, we get that little slide number at the bottom top, bottom left corner of the slide. And if we duplicate the slide, as you can see, we get slide number 3. That's awesome. It is fully functional. Okay, my friends, and now let's just insert this beautiful greenish looking circle. So once again, let's jump into the insert tab. Let's go into shapes. We can turn on the slide guides as well so that we can better see how to align that shape, that circle. And now let's just draw a nice looking circle. Let's make sure it is nicely aligned inside of those two pointy shapes. You can hold down the Control Shift keys to resize from the center. And by the way, to turn off the slide guides, you can just hit Alt F9. That's nice. And for the fill color for this circle, let's use accent 3. Once again, for the line width, let's use 1 point and let's add some line transparency 50%. And let's make sure we are using the same shade of black. Okay, and as you can see, we have this curved text inside and we have the same logo shape. So let me just select this logo from the CTA button and let's just move it over here. Let's make sure both of these guys are centered aligned. And now let's just duplicate this line title. We'll reuse it to create that curved shape. And now let's just type in anything that we wish. For example, your super awesome slide. Okay. And by the way, at the end of this text box, I'm adding one little asterisk just for fun. Hopefully it will make this text design even more elegant. And let's make it bold so that it stands out a bit better. And now let's go to shape format. Let's go to text effects. Let's go to transform and let's pick this preset, which makes this text rounded just like that or curved. So first of all, let's check what was the size of the circle and let's make this text box pretty much the same, but a bit smaller. So let's use 4 centimeters for the height and width. This way it looks proportionate. That's nice. And by the way, as you can see, once we select the text, we get this yellow bubble. So let's make sure it pretty much connects to itself, just like that. And we can hold down the Control Shift keys to resize this rounded and this curved text until it looks the way we want it to look. And now we can just select all of these guys and group them into a single group. And let's add a spin animation to all of these guys. Let's make sure the animation starts with previous animation duration 10 seconds. Okay. And in the animation options, let's make sure that this animation is repeated until the end of slide. And this way, this circle will be rotating until we go to the next slide. That's awesome. And now we can use the animation painter and paste the same animation to any other element on the slide that we wish. We can change the duration for these two last animations if we wish to something faster, for example, 5 seconds. Okay. And next, let me show you how we can add those shadows or those soft glows below some of the shapes. So first of all, let's just insert a simple circle and let's just use this green color. Let's remove the outline. Now let's go into shape formats. Before that, let's make sure that the circle is a bit bigger and let's add soft edges effect. Let's make sure it is maximum soft edges effect. And let's move it to the exact position where the green circle is. Of course, you can move it wherever you would like to move it. And let's just send it to back so that it is below the green circle. Now let's just make a duplicate and this duplicate will be a glow or, you know, a shadow for this CTA button. And let's just make sure that we change its fill to accent 2 and let's just send it to back. Once again, I'm using those productivity shortcuts by BrightSlide to send those fuzzy shapes to back. That's awesome. Okay, so we're pretty much finished. Let's check it out on the full screen. Everything is spinning, especially this logo is spinning. I think I didn't want to spin that text, only that shape. So let me quickly fix that. We can select this logo, hit Control Shift G to ungroup. So now we should be able to select this guy, which is animated, and paste the animation. So let's select this guy. Let's click on Animation Painter and let's paste the animation to this guy. Okay. So now everything should be looking correct. Okay, so all of these shapes that should be spinning are spinning and the rest of the shapes are looking beautiful. We have some elegant fonts. We have these awesome looking shapes on the right side. We have some fuzzy glows. That's nice. We have a custom image placeholder and we have some beautiful harmonious spacing between all of the elements because we have used those slide guides, you know, with those 12 columns and 30 rows. Okay, my friends, and now you know how you can create this beautiful slide in PowerPoint as well. I hope you have found this video useful, and if you did, please smash that like button, and I'll create more videos like this one. Thanks for watching, stay happy, stay healthy, and I'll see you on the next one. Peace.